Students, as we know, we are dealing with the reproduction in bacteria. In our last class, we seen regarding the introduction about the reproduction in bacteria. As we know, the most of bacteria that get reproduced through the binary fission. Here we will see what are the main events that takes place in the reproduction in bacteria. Here the reproduction in bacteria we have mainly of the two types, that is the asexual and the sexual methods. Here under the asexual methods, that is the asexual reproduction, we have the binary fission, endospore formation and the budding. These are the events which are going to take under the asexual reproduction, where in the case of sexual reproduction, that is the genetic recombination, here we will have the transduction, transformation and the conjugation. In the introduction class, we seen little about the binary fission, where the transduction, transformation and the conjugation. Today in this class, we are going to cover this part, that is the complete asexual reproduction in bacteria, where we will see how binary fission takes place, the endospore formation and its germination, and how budding will take place in bacteria. Here the first, that is in asexual reproduction, we know bacteria mostly that multiply by asexual methods. It takes place mainly by binary fission. Most of the reproduction takes place, asexual reproduction takes place by the binary fission and endospore formation. Here in first case we will see regarding the binary fission. This is the commonest method of reproduction and takes place under favorable conditions of temperature, moisture and abundance of food. This is binary fission. When it will takes place, it is the most commonest method. It is takes place when the conditions are under favorable, that is temperature, moisture and abundance of food. In binary fission, a single bacterial cell divides into two equal size cells after developing a transverse cell wall. Here in last class I shown you, if it is the parent cell that is going to divide and which are going to give the two identical genetical daughter cells, that is in the case of the binary fission. Here this binary fission takes place in following steps. It has the replication of DNA, the patterning of DNA and the cross wall formation. These steps which we seen in the binary fission. Here is the first case where the replication of DNA. Here the bacterial DNA divides, means that get replicated to form an exact copy or the replica of the original DNA. That is, if it is the parental cell where it get replicates to give the similar to daughter cells. If it has the DNA D, these both daughter will also have the DNA D. Just assume DNA D. This is in case of replication of DNA. Here this parent cell get replicated and which will give the two daughter cells. As we know the process, this is the bacterial cell where we have the DNA, that is the genetic material, that is get replicates. And here how the cell modify, and the lastly which gives two identical daughter cells, as we seen in the introduction class. Here the patterning of DNA, here the DNA of parent cell that is attached to the mesosome. Where we will find the mesosome? If it is the bacterial cell, this is the flagella. Here the plasma membrane which has the these kind structures, these bulge structures which are attached to the plasma membrane. Here the patterning will takes place. See, this is the plasma membrane. These are the mesosomes present. Here, what will happen? Here, the DNA of the parent cell get attached to these mesosomes in the bacterial cell. During replication, both DNA and mesosomes are duplicated. While replication, this parental DNA and these mesosomes both get replicated simultaneously. A membrane is synthesized between the DNA mesosome attachment sites, and each mesosomes and DNA pushed properly into the daughter cells, where later we see the partition, where this replicated DNA and the mesosomes, these are get equally divided to the two daughter cells. This is in patterning of DNA. Next, in cross wall formation, what will happen in cross wall formation? Here the plasma membrane investigates and continues to grow until the two cells are separated. See, if it is the cell where we seen these cells get elongated and get engulfed, this is done by the plasma membrane until these two cells are get separated. This is the function of plasma membrane that separates the two daughter cells from the parental cell. Here the cell wall materials are also deposited between the membranes, thus the completing the division of the cell. Here, rather than the plasma membrane, here the materials like cell wall materials also present here. They are get deposited. They help to divide the cells. Here the two events, that is the partition of the cell wall and the cross wall synthesis, these are the two events, that is the partition of the cell wall and cross wall synthesis, occur simultaneously. This here the partition and the cross wall synthesis, this partition and this cross wall synthesis, which occur simultaneously. Since fission is the common method of reproduction, bacteria are commonly called fission fungi or schizomycophyta. These commonly called the fission fungi or schizomycophyta. The daughter cells produced are identical and genetically half the size of the parent cell. Here these synthesized daughter cells, these are identical to the to that of this parent cell. If they are parent, these are the daughter cells. These are identically genetically identical, and they are half the size of the parent cell, because if this is the parent cell, they are divided from the parent cell, so they have the half the size of that of the parent cell. And they grow and undergo fission. These daughter cells, they grow up and these undergo the fission. Again, they will give the two daughter cells. This is give the two daughter cells. This change continues. Here, generally cells formed are separated. See, if it is the parent cell which divided and gives the two daughter cells, these can be separated, or else in some cases these do not separate. This forms like a chain. This forms like a chain in some exceptional cases. They do not separate and gives rise to the chains of the bacteria. Here, when the environmental condition is favorable, a bacterium may show fission once in every 20 minutes. Here, time duration is when the all the conditions are favorable, the bacterium may show the fission once in every 20 minute. Here, one fission that takes place in every 20 minutes, starting with the single cell, such a rate multiplication would give two cells in 20 minutes. See, if it is the one cell, that will give the two cells. These two cells, those are formed with the duration of 20 minutes, where these cells replicate and divide gives the four cells. These four cells, which takes 40 minutes, whereas eight cells are formed. These eight cells are formed under the duration of 1 hour. It has been estimated that a single bacterial cell due to repeated fission may be produced 72 billion cells in just 72 hours. See, this is noted that the single bacterial cell, only one bacterial cell that is capable of giving the 72 billion cells in just 72 hours. Just a matter of 72 hours, it replicate, because this is the chain system. One cell that replicate and divides give the two cells, 2 to 4, 4 to 8. The number doubles here. It has been logically estimated that if a bacterial cell takes place 60 minutes to fill a cup completely, then to fill up a half of cup, it would take only the 55 minutes. If assume we have one cup where we have to fill the bacterium, that is the that cells replicate and they filled the cup. To fill this cup, it required the 60 minutes. To fill the half cup, it requires 55 minutes. And after the 20 hours of the unstrict growth, a mass of 18 mg would result from a single bacterium. See, if you leave as it is to multiply, after the 20 hours of unrestricted growth, we will get the mass of 80 microgram of the bacterium. When we will wait, it will give us the 80 microgram. That is only from the single bacterium. That is this 80 microgram under the duration of 20 hours. Completion of division, we will get the mass of the 80 microgram of from the single bacterium. This type of bacterial growth is generally referred as explosive growth, because this is the rapid growth. Hence, it is referred as the explosive growth. Such a rapid rate of increases of bacteria is the reason for the spoilage of the foodstuff, curdling of the milk, and quick spread of the infection. This is the reason how we get the milk into the curd, the conversion of the milk to the curd. That is the rapid process. How it is? This is due to the explosive growth. See here, this is the binary fission in bacteria. This is the bacterial cell. The DNA attached to the cytoplasmic membrane. Here, this is the cytoplasmic membrane. Here we get the mesosomes. This DNA is attached to the cytoplasm and the mesosomes. Next, the cell enlarges and DNA duplicates. Here, see, this cell get enlarges. This parental DNA get replicated along with the mesosomes attached to the plasma membrane. Next, the cell wall formation takes place. See, this the cell wall formation takes place. Here, this duplicated DNA divides equally into the two parts and forms the two daughter cells. See, this is the case here. Cell divides into two cells and the DNA is partitioned into each future daughter cell, which will give the two partitioned daughter cells. These are the two future daughter cells which grow independently. Here, see. Here the cell separates. It separates the cell. Here we have the independent daughter cells, which are genetically identical to that of the parental cell, but in the size it is smaller, means it is the half to the parent cell, because it is get replicated by the parent cell itself. This is in the case of the binary fission in bacteria. Next comes the endospore formation. Here, when the conditions are unfavorable, these bacterial cells undergo the endospore formation. This is in the case when this is in unfavorable condition. Here, example like a bacillus and the Clostridium sporocercina, these form a thick-walled, highly resistant bodies within the cells called the endospores. What are these endospores? These are the thick-walled, highly resistant bodies within the cells. See, if it is the cell, they form thick-walled, highly resistant bodies within the cell. These are called the endospores. Where endospore, this is from the Greek terminology. Endo refers to the inside and the spores refer to the seeds. Where the seeds, those are formed inside the bacterial cell. Here, these formed endospores, these are resistant to the chemicals, radiation and heat. This is important. These are resistant to the chemicals, radiation and heat. Some endospores may resist even boiling for prolonged periods. If we boil the bacterial cell for the prolonged period, even it will not disturb by the heat or the other external factor, because these are resistant to the chemicals, radiation and the heat. It has been observed that some endospores have remained viable even for the centuries. This is reported that when we have the some examples which have remained for the centuries, they are even viable. This is because due to this resistance capacity. How it will get that resistance? Here, the highly resistant nature of the endospore is due to the presence of compounds like DPA, that is the dipicoclonic acid, nucleopeptide polymers, calcium and very low water content. This is the combination how we will get the resistant endospore cell. See, here we have the DPA, that is the dipicoclonic acid, nucleopeptide polymers, calcium and the very low rate of the water present in this endospore formed cell. That's why due to this combination, they are highly resistant even for the centuries. See how the endospore formation takes place. This is the bacterial cell. Here we have the cell wall, we have the cytoplasmic membrane, we have the genetic material, that is the DNA, which this is the vegetative cell of the bacteria. What happens here? Here DNA aligns along the cell's long axis. They get aligned along with the cell's axis. What happens next? The cytoplasmic membrane invigorates to form four spores. See, here it is the cell. The cytoplasm, that is invigorates to form spore cells. These are called the four spores. Next, the cytoplasmic membrane grows and engulfs four spores within a second membrane. The vegetative cell's DNA degenerates. Here, what happens? After the cytoplasmic membrane invigorates, here the cytoplasmic membrane, see here, this side. The cytoplasmic membrane grows and engulfs the four spore within the second membrane. If it is the outer membrane, we will call as the first membrane. This is the inner membrane, we call as the second membrane. Here it get engulfs this here. If it is a cell, this is the second membrane. If it is the four spores, this get engulfs. This kind. Next, what happened here? The cortex of calcium and DPA is deposited between the membranes. See here. These are get deposited here. What are deposited? Here, the calcium, then diplochroic acid, these get deposited here. If it is the cell, it is engulfed here. This is the four spores. This is deposited here to forming the spore. Next, spore coat. The spore coat forms around the endospores. If it is the endospore, it will covered by the spore coat for the protection of the inner spores. Here, the maturation of endospore. The completion of spore coat and increase in resistance to heat and the chemicals by unknown process. Here, if it is the cell where we will get the spore, this is the inner spore, this is the spore coat, and again one more layer is formed, that is the outer spore coat. This is for the resistance to the heat and the other chemicals. When it is formed during the maturation. The outer spore coat is formed during the maturation of the endospore. Next, the endospore is released from the virginal cell. If it is the virginal cell, we have the endospore. This get ruptures which release the endospore. This is viable for the centuries to century. That is due to the because of the presence of the outer spore coat which resists it from the external agency. This is regarding the formation of the endospore. Next, germination. We have the cell. If it is the bacterial cell, it has the endospore here. That is the mature endospore present in the cell. This is done when it is in the unfavorable condition. Here the germination of this endospore takes place when? This takes place when the conditions are under the favorable. Germination of this seed takes place when the conditions are under favorable. But when it is formed during the unfavorable conditions. We will see regarding the germination of this endospore. Here the endospores germinate when conditions become favorable. Under favorable conditions, the cell lose heat resistance and refractivity, release diplochroic acid. See, when under the favorable condition, the cells lose heat resistance, and when it comes under the favorable condition, they lose the resistance of the heat. It will lose the resistance against the heat and refractivity release DPA. This diplochroic acid. It will release the diplochroic acid. It releases in increased metabolic rate. When it releases the diplochroic acid, it will get the high metabolic activity. The imbibition of water and the absorption of salts and nutrients causes the swelling that leads to the bursting of spore coat. See, if it is the spore coat and this is the spore. The spore coat which encloses the endospore, how it will get rupture? It will get rupture by the imbibition process. This cell which will absorb the salts, nutrients which lead to the swelling of the cell. this cell gets swelled by the imbibition process. Later it will get ruptured. This coat get ruptured and this endospore is released out of the endospore coat. The contents come out and develop into a bacterial cell. This content which will come out and which will act as the individual bacterial cell, which develop as the individual bacterial cell. This is in case of the germination. Here we have the photograph of the actual endospore. We observe under the microscope. This is the structure which we observe under the microscope. That is the bacterial endospore. Here we will have the outermost layer, that is the outer spore coat. We have the inner spore coat. The central one is the central core, which includes nuclear material and the spore cytoplasm. The spore cytoplasm and nuclear membrane constitute the central core. We have the cortex region. This is the cortex region, which have the, we have the spore coat. In spore coat, we have the outer and inner. Again, in the cortex, we have the outer cortex and the inner cortex. This is the outer cortex and this is the inner cortex. Next, we have the outer membrane, that is the cell outer membrane. Again, we have the exosporium. This is the exosporium, see, which holds the endospore structure. This is regarding the structure of the bacterial endospore. Here, the endospore, these may have the different shapes, such as it may be of this kind, or it may be of this kind, or else this kind and this. These are the size and shapes that varies in the endospores, which comes under the bacterial sexual reproduction. Here need to remember is when these endospores are formed. These endospores are formed when the condition is unfavorable. But when these get germinates, these get germinates when they get the favorable condition. This is important to remember how they are formed and when they get germinated. Next comes the budding in bacteria. Here the some bacteria, that is example like Rhodopseudomonas, Acidophilia, Bgd bacterium bifidus. These are the examples which reproduce by the process of budding. This reproduction, that is asexual reproduction, budding, which shown by these species. It involves the development of a small protuberance. What is this small protuberance? This is nothing but the bud. The bud is called as the small protuberance. At one end of the cell, it is formed at the one end of the cell, means the bud is formed at the one end of the parent cell. Here the genetic material duplicates, divides, and one part of that moves into the growing bud. The bud slightly enlarges and separates from the parent cell. In the diagram we have, see, this is the parent cell where we have the small protuberance, that is the development of the protuberance. How? See, if it is the parent cell, this is the genetic material which will move to the one side. It will move to the one side and it will make enlargement of cell at the one end. This is at one end. Later, here the genetic material duplicates and divides, and here one part, this duplicated DNA of one part that will go into the this
newly formed bud. What will happen here? See, it will divide here. It is the parent cell. This is the newly formed daughter cell. Here it is, genetic material is divided. Here the cell enlarges. The parent cell enlarges. And this is detached from the parent body, and which is called as the bud. This is called as the bud. Later it will act as the individual cell. See, this is best example in case of the yeast. If it is the parent cell, it has the bud formation, it is detached from the parent cell. This survive as the individual bacteria. This is in the case of budding in bacteria. This is regarding asexual reproduction. Today we seen regarding the binary fission, the endospore formation and the budding. These all are the events which comes under the asexual reproduction in bacteria. In next part we are going to see regarding the reproduction that is in sexual form, that is the transduction, conjugation and the transformation, that is comes under the sexual reproduction. That we'll see in next class. Thank you.